Hello and welcome to a new video presented by Telescope Service and from me, I'm Thorsten. And in today's video, I want to talk about the TS-55mm spotting scope. So the exact name is TS-SP-55Z, but I will link all the items that I mention here also in the description below so you can follow these links to the shop. Spotting scope. Where can you use a spotting scope? Well, it is super versatile. You can use it mostly in daylight observing, maybe for birds, animals. You can do plane watching with it, also flying planes. You can use it in sports, for example, for archery or shooting, to have a proper view on your target face. Even if it is 70 or 100 meters away, this little spotting scope does its job very well. And of course, it is also usable in astronomical observing. So, for example, large and bright star clusters are a perfect target for the spotting scope. The moon is possible to observe the surface of the moon. All these things are possible with it. So, some technical features. So, it comes in a waterproof, or let's call it rain-resist housing. So, you can't put it underwater, that's not working, but it is rain-resistant, so this will not harm the system at all. Maybe you then should protect the front lens because you don't want to get raindrops on the front lens. That's not that good. And also the eyepiece. Talking about the eyepiece, this one is screwed on here, and it is a 1¼-inch eyepiece, and it has this adjustable ring here to adjust the magnification. You can choose between 18 times magnification up to 54 times. So pretty broad range for all possible observing options. On the top of the tube you have the focusing knob, a rubber coated focusing knob, good to handle. And on the bottom there's the photo tripod connection. Well, that's basically it, that's all of it. Well, you have also this very common 45 degree angle view into the spotting scope to make it more convenient when having it on the tripod, that you can look some way like this through it. With this small spotting scope here, you get also, of course, a transport bag to it and also a table tripod. This one here. So it is really a table tripod. It's super small, but very rigid. It is stable. There's not much to it. You can rotate it, you can lock it in place, and you can, of course, also adjust the height of the mounted spotting scope. Let me just quickly mount it. And this knob here is also an interesting thing. This is a fine adjustment for the height or for the altitude that you look to. So this is very, very fine adjustment here, but it is limited in range to a couple of degrees. So this is basically all to tell about the spotting scope itself, but I want to show you another interesting piece of equipment. When you are doing observing with the scope, you may come to a point where you think, oh wow, I would love to take a photo of a particular subject, maybe a rare animal or something. But you don't have a camera with you and you can't connect the camera here. But what you have with you is a smartphone. And therefore, we have this universal smartphone holder. And it is called universal because it fits to nearly every smartphone and it fits to nearly every optic. So the only thing that is needed is a 1¼-inch eyepiece because it is clamped on the eyepiece. Okay, now you have a better view of the holder. So the first thing you have to do is, the first thing you have to do is you have to assemble it because it comes in parts. So you have to assemble all the things together, but that's not an issue. That's pretty straightforward. And then you have to clamp it on your eyepiece in a way like this. With this first setup, we are starting with portrait view. That means the smartphone will be in that orientation. So what you want to achieve is you want to align the camera of your smartphone exactly over the eyepiece of the spotting scope. And you achieve this by moving it left to right, which is done with this long arm here. There's a rotating knob here. And turning this, you can move the smartphone very, very precise in left or right direction. The next thing is this knob here, which moves the smartphone up or down. And the third thing is this knob here, which allows you to adjust the distance from the smartphone to the eyepiece. So let's call it in or out. And to adjust the lower things, you have to loosen this locking screw in the back. Unfortunately, when loosening this locking screw, it gets a bit unstable. So you have to find the proper way where it's not too unstable, but still movable. And there's also a bit of play here in this little gear. Be aware of that, so you have to overcome that backlash when changing the directions. But when you're used to it after 5-6 minutes, then that's a no-brainer, so no problem. Well, then we can connect our smartphone here, put it just in. Unfortunately, I can't focus it here inside the room, so I have to find just something bright. For the first setup, it's always good to focus on a pretty good identifiable target, maybe a tree or something that is very distinctive. So then we put in the smartphone. And now we have to find the right place. And here we go. So now let's adjust the distance. Exactly, in a way like this. So this is the view you can expect. The thing is, this is not a real replacement for a telephoto lens. It is a visual observing tool, so this smartphone connection is just an option. And the thing is, we want to project this circular image that you can see through the spotting scope onto a square sensor of your camera in the smartphone, and that leads to these corners. So here in the middle, this is the interesting part. And because that looks a bit weird, when taking the photo this way, you just use your digital zoom to fill the frame completely. And of course, you can use this mode as for videos too. That's working exactly in the same way. Maybe when doing a video, you want to have it rotated like this to have the video horizontal as normal on TVs. Okay. So far, these were the most important informations about the TS55mm spotting scope. I hope you liked the video, I hope it was informative for you. If you have any further questions or comments, feel free to drop a comment below or send us an email, we would really appreciate it. Thank you very much for viewing, and until next time, bye bye.